Bray Wyatt, Becoming Immortal, is a 2024 TV documentary directed by Steve Consonanti, which tells the story behind one of the most revered and mysterious characters in WWE history and the man himself, Windham Rotunda, who had never been documented until now. This is the true story of Bray Wyatt's rise to worldwide fame as a WWE superstar and the struggles and successes that came with being a creative visionary. Just a little bit of background on the real Bray Wyatt. Windham Lawrence Rotunda was born on May 23, 1987, and unfortunately lost his life on August 24, 2023, at the age of just 36. He was an American professional wrestler and was best known for his tenure in WWE under the ring name Bray Wyatt from 2009 until his death in 2023. Rotunda was the third generation wrestler, following in the footsteps of his grandfather, Black Jack Mulligan, and his father, Mike Rotunda, and his uncles, Barry and Kendall Windham. His younger brother, Taylor, is also a wrestler under the name Bo Dallas. Alongside his brother, he held the FCW Florida Championship Wrestling Tag Team Championship twice, while in WWE's then in-developmental territory, Florida Championship Wrestling. He wrestled under various ring names between 2008 and 2012 in FCW, and wrestled on WWE's main roster from 2010 to 2011 as a member of the Nexus under the ring name Husky Harris. After returning to WWE's developmental territory, which had been rebranded NXT, Rotunda was repackaged as Bray Wyatt. Portrayed as a villainous leader of a bio-dwelling cult called the Wyatt Family, he returned to the main roster alongside the Wyatt Family members Luke Harper and Eric Rowan in 2013. He subsequently became a one-time WWE Champion, two-time WWE Universal Champion, one-time SmackDown Tag Team Champion alongside Harper and brief Wyatt Family member Randy Orton under the Freebird rule, and one-time Raw Tag Team Champion with Matt Hardy. After a hiatus in August 2018 to April 2019, Wyatt returned with a new split personality gimmick that saw himself switch between two characters, Bray Wyatt, who was a Mr. Rogers-esque children's TV host, and The Fiend, which was a grotesque monster resembling an evil clown. He was released from WWE in July 2021, but returned at the 2022 Extreme Rules with a new character that claimed to be his real-life self, while gradually reincorporating his previous personalities in addition to new ones. In what became his only televised match during his return, he defeated LA Knight at the 2023 Royal Rumble. The following month, he took a medical hiatus due to a COVID-19 diagnosis that exacerbated a pre-existing heart condition. He died of a heart attack on August 24th at the age of 36. There is an end credits interview with Mark Calloway where he talks about his involvement with narrating the documentary and meeting Windham and Taylor when Mike used to wrestle him. Also in the post-credits dedication to Windham, glitches to reveal their Bray Wyatt lantern lighting back up, while a mysterious voice is heard shouting, "Run!" But then a shadowy figure appears in front of the reactivated lantern that teases the return of the Uncle Howdy character, played by Taylor Rotunda. The show also introduces us to what Bray Wyatt's new Fiend costume would have looked like, a costume unfortunately he would never get to debut. Now, as I've discussed previously on this channel, I'm a massive wrestling fan, so when I saw this documentary was being released, I knew I had to see it. This is a beautiful tribute to one of the most brilliant and unique minds in wrestling history. Now look, Bray was not known for his in-ring specialty, and sometimes it was hard to tie up the wonderful creative mind that he had with, of course, lacing up a pair of boots and entering the squared circle in order to have a wrestling match. But there's no doubting that Bray Wyatt was a unique and creative force unlike any other in wrestling history. It's almost a waste that a guy like Windham didn't go into Hollywood sooner and create these horror spectacles. As you could see, he just had a mind for that kind of storyline. Although I absolutely loved his creations within WWE. Firstly from the Bray Wyatt cult family, which was superbly done, and allowed wrestlers like Eric Rowan and the unfortunate late John Huber, who unfortunately lost his life at just the age of 41, to get some traction within the WWE. One of my favorite characters, though, has to, of course, be The Fiend. I remember watching the Firefly Funhouse segments, being amazed at the originality, and sometimes even sitting back and wondering, was I actually watching a wrestling show? Or just a YouTube skit? The Mr. Rogers-esque inspired segments were groundbreaking and original and had never been done on a wrestling show before. Of course, this was all just leading to the alternate character, the split personality of The Fiend, which I remember being introduced and absolutely blown away by, with his fantastic entrance theme. Bray really played into the grandiose spectacle of wrestling. He pushed the limits of reality, but allowed you to suspend your mind in favor of the imagination, of the fantasy, and the pure unadulterated escapism that wrestling can provide. Unfortunately though, he was booked poorly, my lead promoter at the time, Vince McMahon, and the character fell away over time. Although I will never forget the pandemic affected WrestleMania in 2020 when him and John Cena had a match, if you can call it that, known as the Funhouse Match, which played off all their history and had different skits and segments. It was really groundbreaking and unique. This documentary though goes into the behind the scenes. You hear his family speak about him and what kind of man he was outside the ring, which truly makes this documentary so captivating and incredibly emotional. There's also plenty of never-before-seen footage and accounts from current and past WWE personnel who worked with him. I feel this documentary really seems to capture who this man was and what he meant to those closest to him. I personally love the touch here of The Undertaker, or Mark Calloway, actually narrating the story. Yes, of course, he's not the most professional in this regard, as he's not a professional narrator, but it just adds a sort of personal touch, as of course he had taken Bray Wyatt under his own wing. Unfortunately, we lost Bray Wyatt far too soon, at just the age of 36, leaving four children behind. He will leave a complicated legacy, but there is no doubting the man's originality and talent. Now, obviously, if you're a wrestling fan, this is a must, but even if you're not, it's really a true insight into a creative genius and a man taken from us far too soon, who left an undeniable mark and legacy upon the world of professional wrestling unlike any other. This is a truly haunting, incredibly emotional and sad piece of documentary filmmaking, but brilliantly done, insightful, fascinating, well-researched, and put together with a lot of heart. Bray Wyatt, Becoming Immortal, gets a 9 out of 10.